Let's begin the remaining journey. Our very next guest for the today is Mr. Avinash Agrawal, Director, Food Jockeys, Master Franchisee of Classic Rock Cafe, Regional Franchisee Cocoberry. Sir, may I have your permission to please begin? Thank you, sir. Sir was born and brought up in Pune. After his graduation in civil engineering from MIT Pune, he joined GE Medical Systems X-ray division for training in Six Sigma quality management systems. Thereafter, he joined the family business Veena Industries Limited, which was started by his father and uncle, both IIT Kanpur graduates. He began by driving the implementation of the ISO 9001:2000 quality management system across all plants and businesses. Subsequently, he had set up a new division within the business for manufacturing and selling of diesel generators. He worked as the head of the division for 10 years, during which the company was one of the largest manufacturers of the generator sets in the country. He was later responsible for manufacturing, HR, admin, accounts, and quality functions across all manufacturing units. About 2 years ago, he left his family business and started his own venture in the food and beverage business. He became the master franchisee for India for an American chain called Classic Rock Cafe Co. The first outlet in India was opened in Pune in Kalyani Nagar in May last year. It is a large cafe bar, lounge and live performance venue spread over 15,000 square feet. Apart from this, he and his family have invested in certain startups that are in space missile guidance system, drones, solar, weather sending equipments and driverless car technology. He and his father also organize a large number of startup meets and are mentors to various startups in the city. His personal interests include being an avid reader, music enthusiast, and past professional DJ. He also contributes a lot of his time towards the NGO Roundtable India that he is a member of and that work towards the building school infrastructure for underprivileged children. Now, I request sir to kindly address the batch.
I think my introduction sounded a bit too fancy compared to what it actually is. It's a lot simpler, but I think credit to the people who do very good content writing, so they make something that's a very good marketing tip for all of you to start off with itself, that whatever you're doing, you know how to write it well and it'll sound very good. So what I'd like to do is that while through my introduction, my life's journey has been briefly captured, I'll just go through maybe a little bit earlier stages of it also, and then quickly to where we are now, and then post that or maybe during that, any questions that the people, the audience would like to ask regarding any of the areas that they find that I've had, you know, opportunity to have an experience in, you all can ask me, and so we'll try to keep it as interactive as possible. I think you're all here for the first day, so most of you don't know each other too, so maybe during that you'll also get to know your colleagues and your co-students a bit as about them. So this college I've seen over the years that is very focused on entrepreneurship, and I think all of you would be knowing that when you happen to join here, and it's a very important part of the way you do things. It doesn't have to be that you're starting your own business, it could also be within your own job that you may be doing later, and entrepreneurship tends to start very early, and usually in your younger days, your entrepreneurship is linked to something that is part of maybe your passion or your hobby. So like it was said, I am an avid reader. So I used to collect a lot of comics. By the age of 5 or 6, I was reading all the time. My brother, my parents, everyone used to have so the typical Archies and Amachitra Kathas and all that. So I had more than 300 comics. So the supposed entrepreneur in me decided that let's start a library. So at the age of 7, I started a library trying to make people come and borrow my comics for a rupee each or something, and which was also fun. So you made other people come and take your books, which anyway they were taking but not giving me any money for it, because you tend to take books from your friends or borrow them. Because of the fact that it was a library, I had to note who is taking it so I could ask for it back, because usually books don't come back to us when you give them. We rarely get it back, or we rarely remember to give it back for that matter. So at least I managed to get back all my books. So even at a very small step, but it made me realize later on in life that just that small step of making it a library made me carry forward all my books even to this day, where most of my childhood comics or books are with me, except the ones that I decided to give away by choice. So moving ahead, as an interest in music, and probably the truth behind it is a very big fear of dancing at that point of time. So I ended up becoming a DJ, usually because I used to hide behind the music player to avoid dancing, and then people said, anyway, you're sitting there, kuch kar nahi rahe, tu ja ke gaane to baja. So it ended up that me and a friend of mine would be sitting with bags of cassettes at that point of time at the age of 15, 16. And we started playing. We had a big group of 40, 50 people as friends, and obviously they used to be happily dancing, and they're like, okay, we've got a bakarai here, so now this guy can at least do the work for us. So it started off that way, literally, that we were by accident thrown into the spot of playing music, and over a period of a few months and a year, we ended up doing it regularly, because then there are 40, 50 friends, each of them have birthdays, then their friends, then your college events. We started doing it in a better way. We started getting in CD players. So from carrying three big bags of cassettes and two cassette players, and then to one CD player, and obviously now right now we just carry one pen drive, but that's a very recent phenomenon that we need to come to. But that's how we progressed again. So for almost 6 years we were doing DJing, where starting from charging 1,000 rupees or 2,000, or often initially not even charging, you could charge the market rate as a DJ, or what were the 5,000, 10,000, 15,000, or your New Year rates. And point being, again, you become a slight professional while doing that, because you have to deal with vendors, you have to deal with customers, you have to deal with the customer as the host and his guests, who are also your customers in a way. And obviously it's a lot of fun also, that when you're doing DJing, you get it to be in touch, it's considered to be the cool thing. Maybe obviously people have some misconception about some of the romantic opportunities DJs get, but it's not always true, so don't get into it for that, please. We are normally too busy behind the console. But yeah, it's something during my I'll say 11, 12, 10 across my engineering, which I would do. We used to play at all the college festivals across MIT or all the other Pune colleges. We had some scary people also calling us, where you had very weird expectations or different things, like in the COEP regatta. So it's on the boat, so your whole system is going on the river on the boat, and they're rowing and they're having a competition, and you have to play the music over there, or something for a political rally where your friends ask you, and then you are with Chandrachur Singh, and you're going on the street with Chandrachur Singh in the jeep, and you're playing Chappa Chappa 100 times because that's the only song he recognized by. So yeah, you have your different challenges, but that again is when you take up anything which comes out of passion or compulsion, it's has its positives, and you have to then take the side responsibilities that also come with it. And but definitely at the end of that journey, you will find all of those at that time will appear to be a pain, but later on you look back and say, thank God I went through that experience, because it's something you cherish and you learn from. Obviously after that, I was in college, I finished, and we were supplying equipment to G Medical Systems, and they wanted someone to come and learn Six Sigma because they are very strong in Six Sigma. So we were like, if we send an employee and he leaves just after learning Six Sigma, we have lost the knowledge and the employee. So it's a waste. So I was again, you know, told, okay, you have just come out of college, वैसे भी तू कुछ कर नहीं रहा, तो you start there first. Also, it helps to learn something working outside before joining your own business. Some of you out here, maybe those who have an existing business and may be looking at joining that or adding to it at some point of time. So in fact, so before I would go ahead, I'd like to know that any of you here have any existing or childhood entrepreneurship activities going on, which you can talk about in the public forum here. I mean, if someone, like last year I had asked, someone was doing a bakery, someone was repairing mobiles, people were, you know, coming very interesting stuff. So it would be nice to know if anyone, you just put a hand up and we'd like to hear briefly if any of you are already doing something or did something in the past. So yeah, do you have anyone here, any entrepreneur already existing? Okay, so you guys would have a start ahead of you. Do we have any artists over here, any musicians, singers, dancers? Yeah, so what are you into?
Hello sir, my name is Jayan Sindayan, and I'm from Jabalpur, Madhya Pradesh.
Okay.
I am a singer, actually.
Okay, that's very good to know. Great, great, great. I think these are useful traits in college. You need to have a singer, a guitarist, or something. I'm sure admission day, this may be what criteria they can. Yeah, Priyo, please.
My name is Anant. I'm from Vijayawada, Andhra Pradesh. I'm a singer.
Okay, great, great. Yep.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Kunal Sen. I am from Raipur, Chhattisgarh, and I'm singer and little bass guitarist and bassist.
Okay, very nice. That's good. So I think you almost have a band forming very soon out here. Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Drums, yeah.
My name is Debargo Mukherjee. I'm from Siliguri, West Bengal. Sir, I'm actually a street magician. I used to perform for a show back in my like in West Bengal. And about the sir, I actually have an idea, but I actually need a coder for it. So the thing is not actually working now. But I'm actually looking for someone who can work on it. So that is, I have an idea, but the thing is not working now. So yes.
So I think for that you are all in the right atmosphere, because you are 180 odd students plus your batches after you or your seniors, and you're now your alumni. So it's like a startup atmosphere or a co-working space that you require something, you have an idea, you'll ask your friends, someone may be very good at what you need, and you may soon find out that someone is helping you get a solution over here itself. So I'm sure you can discuss that, you'll have certain forums or friends that what you need, and I'm sure that will come out. So, but
thank
good
you.
To
Hopefully.
Know that you at least have the idea in your head and you're trying to get it solved.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks. Okay, so moving on. So I spent 6 months in G Medical Systems, partly to learn how work gets done outside of your own business, because however professional you may think you want to be, but when you join your own business, you're still the boss or the boss's son or whatever it is, and the employees and the people will look at you in that way to some extent. And usually when we want to join our own businesses, so again, I mean, any of you here who are with an existing family business or something that your family is into, and you either are looking at joining it or maybe adding to it, so do you have anyone here with the existing business? Yeah, so just can hear from a couple of people as to what they're into.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
My name is Sagar. I'm from Rajkot, Gujarat, and I'm having a family business of cotton industries.
So are you planning to be part of that at some point?
After PGDM, I'll be planning to join or start my own.
Okay. No, that's nice. Okay. Yes. Who else? I saw a couple of hands. Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, my name is Apurva Gupta. I'm from Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh. My family holds a business of utensils.
Okay.
So for that, I plan something else to start my own venture.
Okay, that's nice
to know. Yeah. Anyone else here?
Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
My name is Chirag Khatri. I'm from Jalor, Rajasthan. My father is a businessman. He's engaged in granite manufacturing firm. We procure rock from mines and process it in our own factory. So I'm planning, after completing MBA, to join my father's business and taking it to the further level expansion and establishing different branches in different cities. This is my
good. That's nice to know. That's nice to know. Yeah. Could you have someone over here, please? For the, you have the mic? Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
My name is Farin Saudagar.
Okay, that's very nice to know. So you plan to be part of that at some point? I'm not sure. Okay. Great. So yeah, so like we have someone out here from Rajasthan who wants to join his father's business and grow it. Someone else may also have planned for their own venture. So the point being that it's useful to work a little bit outside before you join your own business, because when you join your own business, you want to bring some changes, you want to bring some improvement, you want to see as an external person as to jo abhi yahan pe ho raha hai wo theek ho raha hai kaise theek kar sakte hai. So when you don't work anywhere else, that's the time where you don't get a chance to experience what's different in the industry compared to what you have been doing in your own place. So it gives you that perspective, and I think it also gives you a lot of respect within your own organization when you join it, and it teaches you how to work in an organization as an employee and not also a boss alone directly when you join it, because that can be very useful to you at some point, because if later, not for your own family business but a new business that you start, when you're working as a boss, it's very important to know and think like an employee too, because only then will you be a good boss. And if you haven't experienced that yourself, then you'll never understand the pains and the issues and the problems that an employee may be facing. And it's like, you know, how ek paidashi raja ban jate, because he's a raja, and so wo praja ki problem samajh mein nahi aati usko, and you know, they offer like Queen Mary Antoinette, that if they can't have bread, give them cake. He's thinking like that, that you don't know what's the fact. So when I joined my own business, I was again told that the existing business is going well, we don't need really anything to be done in this. So I started working on the ISO systems, got the quality system established. We then saw an opportunity in the genset market. We were making part of the components anyway. I got that started. So for me, it was like a new venture. It wasn't existing in our place. So we were lucky in the right place at the right time. The telecom industry was booming. So we made a huge number of gensets every year, supplied to most of the telecom towers that are there across the country for all the telecom companies. That went on well for a few years. Then suddenly the telecom scam came in, and we found that all the money that is in the system has sucked out. Most of the politicians or the companies had either taken it or the business wasn't viable enough. So we found that we have crores of rupees stuck in the market, and companies are shutting down and asking for one-time settlement. Or companies like BSNL, who are, when you ask them for a reconciliation, their way of reconciliation is they'll take you, come here, they'll open a door. Yeh hamara store hai, idhar record hai. चार दिन आदमी रगा दो उसमें और ढूंढ के जो निकालना निकालो. एंड वी आर यूज टू ERPs एंड IT सिस्टम्स फॉर बेसिक रिकंसिलेशन. एंड आई मीन अप टू 3 years बैक यू फाइंड कंपनीज विच आर स्टेट रन, IT हेड्स सपोजिटली आर यूजिंग ओल्ड रूम्स एज रिकॉर्ड्स टू रिकंसाइल योर अकाउंट, विच इज ऑब्वियसली द बेस्ट वे टू नॉट गिव योर मनी. सो कमिंग थ्रू ऑल ऑफ दोज टाइम्स वी रियलाइज इट्स बेस्ट टू गेट आउट ऑफ इट. सो अगेन यू हैव टू नो वॉट बिजनेस हैज इट्स लाइफ, एट वॉट स्टेज इट्स no longer worthwhile to flog the dead horse and get out of it. You may make losses, but you have to cut your losses and stop making any more losses, so that the rest of the money that you have is put in towards something further that can give you profits or returns, rather than trying to keep growing. Because there's a lot of passion behind what we start as fresh, and it's very difficult for any of us to let go and to admit that it's a failure or it's no longer working. And we have sometimes learned the hard way that you extended a bit longer, and then when you have to start something, you don't have anything for that, plus what you were trying to extend gets lost. So while you still have some time to probably reach that stage, but keep that in mind also, that it's not linked only to a big business. It could be anything that you're doing in your day-to-day life, including a relationship, including a small project in your college, or including a subject that you thought you want to do. That yes, if you can do it, if you can't beyond a certain point, give it the due that it is and then move on. So the same way we decided to get out of that, and that's when I got into a more across the board role, rather than looking at a division. I was handling across the company various plants and activities instead of only genset. It was across manufacturing, etc., for the various plants, which again, I mean, it was more for me a little bit boring, because I was to be enjoying something which would be a little bit more creative if the opportunity did. But yes, sometimes you have a phase where you can't get what you want. You have to do what is needed, knowing that what you wanted, you did, it didn't work out, or it needed a break from it. And before you can take the next step, you have to give a consolidation phase where you also settle down, get understanding about what's happening. And it may be a bit difficult at that time, but it's not the thing that is impossible or you take it, regret it, because again, you sit down, you think, you look back on things, and then you start fresh. So that was going on well, and then as again, it seems glorified that I started my own business, but the fact is that one day I just came down in the morning and to getting ready to leave for the factory, and my dad tell me ki kal se te aaj se tumhe factory nahi jana hai. अब लाइक क्यों, क्या हो गया, छुट्टी है क्या, नहीं जाना, नहीं मतलब नहीं जाना है, फ्रॉम टुडे आई वांट यू टू स्टॉप वर्किंग विद द फैमिली बिजनेस. तो लाइक ओके, व्हाट हैपेंड, व्हाट डिड आई डू, समथिंग हैपेंड इन द नाइट, कुछ, आई एम नॉट अवेयर, आई डिडंट गेट एनी कॉल्स. लाइक नो, आई थिंक यू आर स्टिल यंग इनफ टू टेक अ रिस्क टू स्टार्ट अ बिजनेस फ्रॉम स्क्रैच नाउ एंड मे बी फेल. इफ यू वेट फॉर 10 years later एंड देन यू ट्राई टू डू इट, यू वोंट हैव द गट्स और द रिसोर्सेज. or you won't have the time after you finish that journey to come back and start something. Now you are at a stage where you are in your 30s where you can take that call and you can try it. So I want you to start something from scratch where you don't have any support like we give you or gave you when you started the or joined the family business. So while it sounds okay theoretically, but frankly it's a very very scary thought. It's not only being thrown into the deep end of the pool, it's like being thrown into the deep sea with nothing and with 100 sharks swimming below or something like that. So like, and I was happy at that time. I'd done my hard work of 14-15 years. I used to be leaving at 10 o'clock, coming back at 6, 6:30, having people to get work done for me, having my own time, and suddenly like from scratch, So literally from almost that day, except for the bare minimum work that I had three and a half years back, I almost completely got cut off from the day-to-day work except what was needed for the continuity. And fortunately, the team that was with us was good enough or is good enough to take over the things that I was doing. And then we were like, kya karna hai? So I was like, okay, let me get into what was I doing. Okay, DJing. Since I was a DJ, I used to love rock and retro especially. So let's see something entertainment. Liquor everyone likes, so let's see something can be with alcohol. The common saying ki chahe khushi ho ya gum, daru to bikti hai, lagti hai. So, more than drinking, I was fond of the concept of alcohol. So I was looking at, okay, let's go into microbrewery. So I did a lot of research into setting up a microbrewery, almost joined a course. So my brother's in the US, at that time in a state called Oregon, which is got the largest number of microbreweries in the world. And the town next to him is called Beer Town, USA, because it has the largest number of microbreweries. So it's like there's a population of 40,000 and there are 13 microbreweries. So it's like almost a microbrewery per 2,000 people. So while I was doing that, I came across the option of a brand called Classic Rock Coffee Company, which currently we are working with. And in the US, it's primarily a coffee shop with a rock theme. So you can say, imagine Starbucks ke andar ek din se rock theme aa gaya, to wo Classic Rock ban jayega. The difference being that Classic Rock was roasting its own coffee beans in the store. So you have green coffee beans, which normally people never see. And in the outlet, you have a big roaster, which people are actually seeing it being roasted fresh as compared to that. So this concept of going back in the manufacturing stage, which has been caught on, that's why microbreweries do well. People like to go and see it being made in front of their eyes, open kitchen or whatever. So that something we started talking to them, all the discussion happened, we ended up becoming the master franchise for India. But it so turns out in India, no one drinks coffee, I mean comparatively. So US sells more coffee on Monday morning between 6 a.m. and 7 a.m. as India would sell in the entire week across the country. So that's the kind of difference that you see in terms of coffee consumption between India and US especially. So we're like, okay, franchise to le liya, lekin isko coffee se bana ke bechenge to yahan pe kuch fayda nahi hoga, we'll be like not able to do it. So then we use the option ki theek hai, you have a coffee shop, it's a rock theme place, it's like a pub. At 8 o'clock in India, you put someone in a rock theme place like a pub and you tell me drink coffee, you'll get a slap. So you better have, what will people want? The natural demand is for something with beer or alcohol. So we said, let's bring in alcohol, let's make it a restaurant. Luckily, the US first flagship store also had an adjoining space, part of it which they called the club, which had a large stage and a performance venue. So we thought if they are doing it, let us also do it. So we were looking for a large place. So the first place we opened in Kalyani Nagar, which is around 15,000 square feet. So we have an inbuilt amphitheater which fits 400 people, like that Kattawal amphitheater, steps ke saath mein and all of that. So then we sent photos to Classic Rock USA ki humne ye site finalized kiya hai. So bolte, tum, it looks like you are opening the world's largest coffee shop. So we are like, no, it's not the world's largest coffee shop, it's also a lot more than coffee. So that's where Classic Rock as a journey started. And now it's a franchise model, so we have to sell franchise across the country, which itself is a challenge. We just opened our first franchise in Baner a couple of months back, so that's closer to all of you. So I'm sure a lot of you can come, it's maybe around 15 minutes from here. And we opened in May. So in Classic Rock, we again, when you open, it's a very competitive market. So that's, this business is one of the most serious businesses. This business of making people have fun and having a good time is a very serious business behind the scenes. So so we have a lot of live band. That's why I was also asking, because we have a lot of live band, a lot of stand-up comedy, a lot of DJ shows, a lot of karaoke is very popular. We have tied with Red FM, etc. So all the RJs come and perform at a place. So whole focus is a lot of events, activities. We now do a lot of curation. So we do a lot of comedy curation. Especially we have done the largest comedy festival of the country 3 months back with 35 artists coming in, including, if those of you follow comedy, Biswa, Kanan Gill, the top artists, Zakir Khan. So all of Kenny Sebastian. I'll see the girl's face light up normally when I say Kenny Sebastian. Yeah. All of these people perform with us regularly. Now we have just started, in case there are any budding comics amongst you, the countrywide comic hunt open mic, which the first edition was yesterday. So every Sunday for next 3 months, there'll be 10 comics performing along with 3-4 big artists as guest spots. And the best comic will be in this top 15 in the semi-final, and then the final sometime in October. Point being, again, these are all innovations that we realize we needed, because the market is very tough anywhere of every business, including F&B, because you have a lot of established brands, a lot of places that are fighting for the same business. When you those of you, if any, are from Pune, or when you start spending some time here, you'll realize that where you are right now and this area is the current most upcoming area of nightlife in the city. And while every place that opens does well, at the same time, a lot of people are constantly opening, so you have to keep trying new things, how to get people. So, which is again with all of your businesses, you cannot stay like, maybe he's talking of Granite. Now, he may want to move into a different product within Granite, or he has to innovate within cotton. You may change into a different use of cotton, or you may change the material of utensils. So, there are so many things that you can do, because the market is not going to stay quiet. They are not going to say ki haan, ye 15 saal se kar rahe hain, unko khush rehne. Everyone is a wolf out there trying to get their share of the business, because everyone thinks that they are better, everyone needs to survive, and there's enough market also. So please don't remain anytime complacent at anything you do. Please make sure that you're constantly innovating, evolving, reviewing. And what business, what you learn doesn't necessarily have to be the same. So I'll give an example. I'm in the hospitality industry. Now my brother is a doctor, and though he should be in the hospitality, I don't know why they call it hospitality when it's not hospital, but yeah. So he's in the US, he manages hospital, he doesn't treat patients necessarily. So we were at some point talking of him opening a hospital in India. So now imagine I am in the restaurant business, and I am being asked, you know, Kichal, you come and work with me in the hospital and all of that, and I go there. So now a patient comes, very serious, ye wo sab theek jaate, and I say, okay, thank you, come back again soon. So now I'm sure the patient is not going to be very happy with that. Or now I take out a scheme, chalo, happy us, get injured up to 9 p.m. and come and you get, buy one bottle of blood, get one free. So, or if we say that, okay, we have a loyalty program, the more you get injured, the better we'll treat you. Or, okay, you want to have a party, 25 of you can be in an accident together, then we'll give you a group discount. So now these are things which is the way my mind would ordinarily work, but when I have to apply it for a hospital, so it's not exactly going to be there. The only thing similar maybe is that maybe we'll still keep, instead of pretty waiters, pretty nurses, but that's some level of matching. But the same thing works exactly the opposite. So, I mean, if I have to tell a guest that I'm happy to see you, and instead I want them to come again, but I can't say that in hospital to a patient, ki haan, see you tomorrow or see you day after. That's the way we tell our customers. So it's very awkward probably to market in hospital, because how do you tell people that you are there and you want them to come, but you also don't want them to go through the reason that you want them to come. So it's a very difficult way to probably market a hospital directly by addressing guests. So I would probably be the most terrible person to be in PR in a hospital, because probably I would drive away everyone from the first day, or you know, vice versa. So I mean, the only thing that probably would be true between my restaurant and hospital would be the Bloody Mary drink, because that's one thing that is common in both the places. So yeah, as of now we are obviously looking at expanding, getting more people to take our franchise, and we do a lot of outside event curation. For example, like yesterday we had a very challenging show. We had to curate stand-up comedy at RSI, which is a army institute, and it was for the Southern Command head. So he's number 3 in India, General Harris, and he apparently likes stand-up comedy. But so we were told, stand-up comedy chahiye hume, lekin no topics of jokes on religion, nothing on politics, nothing on government, no adult humor, no gali. So like, what is remaining? Have you seen a stand-up show anytime? What do we talk on? you tell me what you want us to have the artist talk on. हाँ वो स्कूल के ज़माने के बच्चे के बारे में स्कूल लाइफ एंड हमने क्या स्कूल एंड कॉलेज लाइफ इज ऑल्सो ऑल अबाउट द थिंग्स यू टोल्ड अस नॉट टू टॉक अबाउट सो देन वी हैड टू फाइंड आर्टिस्ट फॉर हु रेडी टू डू दैट हु हैव हाफ एन आवर ऑफ कंटेंट देन दे सेड अच्छा आगे के दो रो में सब वी आई पी बैठेंगे उनसे बात मत करना ओके स्टैंड अप शो में वैसे होता है यू नॉर्मली एड्रेस द फर्स्ट टू रोज ऑफ द ऑडियंस एंड मेक फन ऑफ देम यानी उनसे बात मत करना उनको देखना भी मत देखो ओके सो नाउ माई आर्टिस्ट आर लाइक स्केर्ड सो लिटरली वी हैड टू फाइंड पीपल हु रेडी टू डू दैट टेक दैट चैलेंज एंड द आर्टिस्ट लकली डिड इट वेल इवन व्हेन दे केम ऑन स्टेज सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल सो वन ऑफ द गाइज सेड कि यूजली इफ आई एम बैड एट माई जॉब आई विल गो होम यू विल गो होम नथिंग द ऑडियंस कैन डू हियर आई एम सिटिंग इन अ रूम फुल ऑफ पीपल हु नो हाउ टू यूज गन्स सो आई एम वेरी स्केर्ड अबाउट इफ आई टैंक इन माई शो फॉर द फर्स्ट प्लेस सो दीज आर द काइंड ऑफ That same artist who is so comfortable doing his shows every day, suddenly was put in a situation and we as curators were, at the end of it, they liked it a lot, everyone went up happy, but these are the kind of challenges which are coming even now. And behind all of this is that the reason we are doing this is that there's a passion to follow and like what we're doing and I think without that, while sometimes what you want becomes a passion, sometimes your passion becomes what you want. It's a question of finding the right thing. Not that I want you all to be scared of this business, but for example, my hours are that I sleep at 5:30 in the morning every day and I wake up at 9:30 and I'm working throughout. So whether from home or from this thing, I have no days which I take off. If I take off, all working is the same because the days when all of us want to enjoy our weekends for me are my busiest days at work. So there is no concept of Saturday, Sunday ko aram kar sakte because my customers are the maximum on those days. My customers are maximum at night. And yes, I do it, I enjoy it, and I'm living with it. But if I wasn't enjoying it, or it wasn't something that I became passionate about, or was, there was no way I could survive this lifestyle for so many years. Because at some point of time, you will say that it's not worth it, I need to be with my family, I need to sleep, I need to do this. And when it does well now, so we find that Kalyani Nagar, we opened, it's been 2 years. Baner, we have opened a month back and already Baner business is more or less what we have been doing after 2 years in Kalyani Nagar. So that satisfaction we are getting is because of the effort we have put in, the recognition people are giving it to the brand, the knowledge that we have gained. So after this time, that effort that has been put in gives some kind of return and satisfaction. So you cannot expect instant gratification in whatever you all do just because it's your passion. You have to stick to it. Please remain with what ideas up to a point. As I said, when you're clear it cannot work, then get out of it, but don't avoid the hard work that comes to make anything work, because unless you are a rare case of a unicorn company or very lucky, nothing comes behind without hard work, and you may not see it on the face of it, whether it's your own students out here, who are some of you who may have been very high scoring students, people who are your toppers, or whether it is your parents' business or anything that you are doing. If people are at the top of where they are, they have put in a tremendous amount of hard work, and without that nothing can happen. So just make sure that you all don't forget that. If you're lucky and it comes easier, enjoy it, but don't take it for granted. So given this range of experiences that I've gone through, I would like to know if anyone has any questions regarding any of the things that either I have spoken or any questions you have in your mind, so I'd like to open the floor to that. Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
My name is Pranav Meshwari. I am from Maharashtra, Mumbai. So my question to you is, how did you manage to overcome the hurdles you have faced while opening your own business?
See, you have to wherever possible, first of all, work with professionals. So in my case, I had no clue about a restaurant and I decided to open one. I had the, which I say is a big advantage, that to some extent, some level of capital money that was offered to me by my family to start off. But even after that, that was like 30% of what I needed. So I actually spent the first 1 year just going to at least 15 banks and convincing them to give me a loan for my business as a startup loan. Apart from that, all the other things that I required, so I tried to hire a professional as a CEO or a senior consultant who knows the business very well, because if you don't know your business and you try to do it, you're going to probably cause problems, so best to get someone who does that. Same way, you I went to someone who is in tax, asked some friend, give me a good CA, so we got a good CA. So all the things that are required to start the business, you start finding the people you think are the right people to guide you in it. You make a lot of mistakes, you stumble a lot, you take a lot more time than what, like if I had to open a new restaurant today, I would do it in maybe 15% of the time it took me the first one, or 50% of the second one. So it's just perseverance and use of the right people around you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for the wonderful session. I'm sure the batch has learned a lot. Thank you.